Hello everyone. Welcome to this video to learn about a feature called Dynamic Connection String using a custom attribute in our Bold BI. Dynamic Connection String feature enables you to modify the connection string of the data sources dynamically to avoid the creation of new dashboards from the same kind of data sources. The result can be viewed in both server and embedding modes. You can get Dynamic Connection String in two ways. One is by using an external API and another using a custom attribute. I will explain about the external API functionality in another video. Now, I will talk about the custom attribute functionality and how to configure a custom attribute. A custom attribute is a piece of code that acts like a parameter, which is replaced anywhere in the query by the users. The attribute name is replaced by the code, which is saved for each user to render the dashboard based on the attribute. These are the types of configuring custom attributes. You can create attributes at user, group, and site levels, and they can be configured to data sources in two ways. One is by adding attributes with a connection string, and the attribute name can be added in the dynamic connection string configuration window. The next is by adding an attribute, like a query parameter, and the attribute name can be added like a placeholder in a custom query. Now, let me explain the different levels of custom attributes. The hierarchy of custom attributes can be defined in three levels. The first one is the user level attribute. This attribute can be set by the site admin for a user in the user management profile page. View the attributes inherited from the group and site level in the user's attribute listing. The second level is a group level attribute. This attribute can be set by the site admin for a group in the group profile page, and the attributes inherited from the site level can be viewed in the group's attribute listing. The third is the site level attribute, which can be set by the UMS admin for a site in the site details page. Among these three attributes, the user level attribute has the highest priority. The group and site level attribute can be overridden at the user level. Also, the site level attribute can be overridden by the group level attribute. Let me explain each level with a demo. To explore this feature, you need to install and deploy the Bold BI server in your machine. To learn how to install and deploy the Bold BI server for creating dashboards, please check the documentation and video links mentioned in the description. I have already installed the Bold BI server and created the K-12 enrollment dashboard. This dashboard is used to track the performance of each institution. Now let's see a demo with the user level attribute. If you have different databases for different users, but with the same schema, you can change the connection string dynamically without recreating the dashboard for each user. I have User 1 database with City Park Elementary School's data and User 2 database with the 7 Pillars Career Academy's data. In this case, you can dynamically change data by adding an attribute at the user level. Now, let me show you how to create and configure a dynamic connection string via custom attribute at the user level. First, you need to add the two users to the Bold BI server. To know how to add and manage users, please check the documentation and video links provided in the description. I have added user 1 and user 2. Now I am going to add the attribute for this. Click user 1 and navigate to the attributes tab. Then click the add attributes button, a dialog will appear. Enter the attribute name and make sure to use the same attribute name for all users so that the user dynamically gets the data in a single dashboard. Provide your connection string for the user 1 database in value section. And click save to save the attribute. Now the added attribute will get listed in the attributes tab. Next navigate to user 2 attributes tab and add the attribute with the same attribute name as user 1. Now, let me explain how to configure these attributes in our dashboard. Click edit dashboard and navigate to the data source page by clicking the data source icon. You can configure the connection attribute in dynamic connection string window for both design view and code view. Here, I am going to show a demo in code view. So, let me switch to code view and click the edit connection button. Enable the dynamic connection string toggle button and click configure. A dynamic connection string configuration window will appear. Here, you will find two options, external API and custom attribute. Choose custom attribute and add the same attribute name created to both users. You will also find two kinds of configuration modes at the bottom of the window. I am going to choose both since I need to view the dashboard with custom attribute in both embedding and server modes. Click Save and reconnect the dashboard. Then, save your data source. Now, let me show the result in the server mode. Click Preview, and you will find the dashboard with all data. To find the User 1 data, click the Select User or Group drop-down. Created Users list will show, choose User 1. Then, the dashboard will render based on the User 1 connection string associated with User 1 database and shows the performance of the City Park Elementary School. To find the data for User 2, click the Select User or Group drop-down. Created Users list will show, choose User 2. Then, the dashboard will render based on the User 2 connection string associated with User 2 database and show the performance of the 7 Pillars Career Academy. Similarly, you can view the dashboards based on different users in the embedding mode. Let me show you the embedded dashboard now. Here, I have already prepared an ASP.NET Core sample and embedded the dashboard in it. To learn how to create and embed dashboards using the ASP.NET Core application, refer to the video and documentation links provided in the description. In this sample, I have added 3 dropdowns for showcasing the dashboard rendering based on user, group, and site level attributes. To achieve this, you need to config the site details in embeddetails.json file and user details in the userdetails.json file and run the sample. After the application is launched, the dashboard is embedded with default admin user with all the institution's data. To find the User 1 data, click the Switch User drop-down and choose User 1. Then, the dashboard will render based on the User 1 connection string associated with User 1 database and shows the performance data of the City Park Elementary School in the embedding mode. To find the User 2 data, click the Switch User drop-down and choose User 2. Then, the dashboard will render based on the User 2 connection string associated with User 2 database and shows the performance data of 7 Pillars Career Academy in embedding mode. So far, I have shown you how to add and configure the user level attribute. And also, the sample dashboard in both server and embedded views. Next, we will see a demo with the group level attribute. If you need to render this dashboard based on grades served from pre-kindergarten to 5th and 6th to 12th in single dashboard without recreating a new dashboard for each grade, you can add 2 attributes in the group level. For this, create 2 groups. To know how to add and manage groups and manage permissions, please check the documentation links provided in the description. I have already created 2 groups, Group 1 and Group 2. In Group 1, I am going to add permission for admin user to get the result with all institutions' data having the grades served from 6th to 12th. In Group 2, I am going to add permission for user 1 to get the result of grades served pre-kindergarten to 5th and pre-kindergarten to 2nd in user 1 database. Now, click on Group 1 and navigate to the Attributes tab, click the Add Attributes button, and a dialog will appear. Enter the attribute name and make sure to use the same attribute name for all groups, so that you can dynamically get the data based on the group in a single dashboard. Provide your query parameter for Group 1 in the Value section. And click Save to save the attribute. Now the added attribute will get listed in the Attributes tab. Next, navigate to Group 2 Attributes tab and add the attribute with the same attribute name as Group 1. Now, let me explain how to configure these attributes in our dashboard. Click Edit Dashboard and navigate to the Data Source page by clicking the Data Source icon. In the Code View section, find the query for your tables. Here, use the query parameter in where condition. To know more about the syntax that be used to add the attribute in custom query, you can check out the documentation link provided in the description. Using this syntax, I replace the attribute name with the name provided in the groups. Run the query and save the data source. Now, to see the result in the server mode, click Preview, and you will find the dashboard with all institutions and grades. To find the Group 1 data, click the Select User or Group drop-down. Created Users and Groups list will be displayed, choose Group 1. Then, the dashboard will render based on the Group 1 attribute with the admin user database and see the performance of grades served 6th to 12th. To find the Group 2 data, click the Select User or Group drop-down. Choose Group 2. Then, the dashboard will render based on the Group 2 attribute with the User 1. Here you will find the group level attribute overriding the User 1 attribute. It shows the performance of grades served pre-kindergarten to 5th alone, since user 1 doesn't have the grade pre-kindergarten to 2nd. Similarly, you can view the dashboard based on different groups in embedding mode. Let me show you the embedded dashboard now. For this, you need to config the group details in the groupdetails.json file and run the sample. After the application is launched, see the dashboard embedded with default admin user with all the institution's data. To find the Group 1 data, click the Switch Group drop-down and choose Group 1. Then, the dashboard will render based on the Group 1 attribute with the admin user database, and you can find the performance of grades served 6 to 12. To find the Group 2 data, click the Switch Group drop-down and choose Group 2. Then, the dashboard will render based on the Group 2 attribute with the User 1. Here the group level attribute overrides the User 1 attribute. It shows the performance of grades served pre-kindergarten to 5th alone, since User 1 doesn't have the grade pre-kindergarten to 2nd. You saw the demo of how to add and configure group level attribute, its behavior based on user level attribute, and the sample dashboard in both server and embedding views. Next, we will see a demo with the site level attribute. I am going to showcase different school districts' performance in Site 1 and Site 2. Go to the /sites link and you will find the site list. You can create multiple sites in the embedded platform only. We don't have support in cloud platform. To learn how to manage sites and share dashboards, please check the documentation link provided in the description. I have created two sites and shared the Site 1 dashboard to Site 2. Now, click on Site 1 name and navigate to the User tab. Here you can add any user to give permission to access the site attribute. I have added admin user. Then, navigate to the Attributes tab. Click the Add Attributes button and a dialog will appear. Enter an attribute name and make sure to use the same attribute name for all the sites, so that you can dynamically get the data based on the site in our dashboard. Add the attribute for Site 1 in the Value section. Next, click on Site 2, navigate to the User tab, and add permission to the admin user. After that, navigate to the Attributes tab and click the Add Attributes button, and a dialog will appear. Add the attribute for Site 2 with the same attribute name as Site 1. Now, to configure these attributes in our dashboard, click Edit Dashboard and navigate to the Data Source page by clicking the Data Source icon. In the Code View section, you will find the query for your tables. Here, I am going to use the query parameter in where condition. To know the syntax to add the attribute in custom query, you can check out the documentation link provided in the description. Using this syntax, I replace the attribute name with the name provided in sites. Run the query and save the data source. Now, to display the result in the server mode, go to your dashboard and click Preview and see the performance of the Site 1 dashboard with the school district Appling County and Clayton County. In Site 2, the performance of Site 2 dashboard with the school district Banks County and Franklin County will be displayed. Similarly, you can view the dashboard based on different sites in the embedding mode. Let me show you the embedded dashboard now. For this, you need to config the site details in the embeddetails.json file and run the sample. After the application is launched, you can see the embedded dashboard. To find the Site 1 data, click the Switch Site drop-down and choose Site 1. You can see the performance of the Site 1 dashboard with the school district Appling County and Clayton County. To find the Site 2 data, click the Switch Site drop-down and choose Site 2. You can see the performance of Site 2 dashboard with the school district Banks County and Franklin County. In this video, I have shown you how to work with dynamic connection string using custom attributes based on the user, group and site levels with an example configuration in a dashboard. I also showed a sample dashboard demo with server and embedding views. You can find the documentation link provided in the description. Please leave a comment for any clarification or additional features you would like to see in Bold BI. Thanks for watching.